गुड आफ्टरनून ऑल ऑफ यू. इन लास्ट लेक्चर आई हैव डिस्कस द ग्रोथ ऑफ एनिमल सेल्स इन कल्चर एंड सेकेंड थिंग दैट इज जनरल प्रोसीजर फॉर सेल कल्चर. टुडे वी विल कंटिन्यू द सेम पॉइंट दैट इज जनरल प्रोसीजर फॉर सेल कल्चर फ्रॉम पॉइंट नंबर 6. देन इट इज सब कल्चर ऑफ द सेकेंडरी ऑफ द कंटिन्यूस सेल कल्चर. आफ्टर द सेल्स इन प्राइमरी कल्चर वेसल have grown and occupied the entire culture substrate. They are subculture for further growth. Then the subculturing it involves gently removing the cells from the substrate with the help of enzymes. Then these enzymes are also used for breaking the protein bonds through which the cells are attached to the substrate. Then next, that is cloning of cell line. A group of cell obtained from primary culture at the first subculture is termed as a cell line. I am repeating C here. So what is cell line? A group of cells which is obtained from primary culture at the first subculture is termed as cell line. That is, which does not indicate homogeneity or the characterization degree of a cell culture. Then a cell line is grown and incubated under the optimum condition, that is 37 degrees Celsius and 5% CO2 in a cell incubator. Then the cell lines develop from cell culture with limited lifetime. The cell lines develop from a cell culture with limited lifetime. However, some cells being mutated undergo continuous multiplication and thus it can be cultured. Sometimes the normal cells can be fused with immortal cells like immortal cell line. Example, monoclonal antibodies. Then the cell lines mostly grow for a limited number of subcultures in a limited time. That is 8 to 10 subcultures in a 12 week. Yes, 8 to 10 subcultures in a 12 week. Then they either stop the process of proliferation or the proliferating and die out or produced continuous cell lines to be grown infinitely. Then there are different cell lines and products. First, human tumor, that is angiogenic factor. Then human leukocytes, that is interferon. Then human kidney, that is product, that is urokinase. Then human kidney cells, human protein. Then dog kidney, canine distemper vaccine. Then cow kidney, foot and mouth disease. Then cheek embryo fluid, vaccine for influenza, measles and mumps. Then duck embryo fluid, vaccine for rabies and rubella. Then mouse fibroblast interferon, that is interferon. Then cell line of mouse, rat or human origin, monoclonal antibodies. In Chinese hamster cells, factor at tissue plasminogen activator. Last, that is contamination in cell culture. The cell culture may be contaminated by different ways. First, that is chemical contamination, and second, that is biological contamination. In chemical contamination, this type of contamination is caused due to the or caused by invisible agent. For example, endotoxins, plasticizers, metal ions, or the traces of chemical disinfectants. Yes, this chemical contamination is caused by or it is due to the visible agent. For example, endotoxins, plasticizers, metal ions, or traces of chemical disinfectant. Thus, it is detected with much difficulties. Then biological contamination. This type of contamination is caused by fast-growing yeast, bacteria, fungi, and generally has visible effects on the culture. That is changes in flow medium, turbidity, or pH. Then, however, the biological contamination by mycoplasmas and viruses demand special detection method as they cannot be usually detected. Then next, primary established and transformed cell culture. That is first primary cell culture, then second established cell culture, then third transformed cell culture. We will see one by one. First, primary cell culture. The primary cells most closely represent the tissue of origin. They are taken directly from tissues and proceed to establish them under optimized culture conditions. Then, because these are derived from tissues and it not modified, they are more similar to the in vivo state and exhibit normal physiology. For this reason, they provide excellent model system for studying the normal physiology as well as biochemistry of cells. For example, metabolic studies, aging study, then signaling studies, and the effect of drugs and toxic compounds on these cells. Then, the primary cell having the limited lifespan. See here, what I'm saying, this primary cells have a limited lifespan and will stop dividing. And after the certain number of cell divisions, and can be more difficult to culture and also maintain that a continuous cell line. Then, the variability induced in primary cell acquired from donors and during these subculture practices is a major challenge faced by researchers who study the cell signaling pathways. Then, researchers prefer to screen the cells for sensitivity to common stimuli before embarking on signaling studies. Then, pre-screened primary cells save the valuable resources as they are stimulated for activation of major signaling pathways. Then, most popular type of primary cells used in research are epithelial cells, fibroblasts, keratinocytes, melanocytes, then endothelial cell, muscle cells, hematopoietic cell, and mesenchymal stem cells. These are the popular type of primary cells that are used by researcher. Then the culture are initially heterogeneous, that it means it represent a mixture of cell types present in the tissues, and it can be maintained in vitro only for a limited period of time. Then the primary cells may be manipulated for indefinite subculture through in vitro process called as transformation. Yes, I am repeating here. The primary cells may be manipulated for indefinite subculture through an in vitro process, which is called as transformation. Then transformation can occur spontaneously, or it can be chemically or virally induced. When a primary culture undergoes genetic transformation, it is provided with appropriate fresh medium and the space, and they divide indefinitely, and it become a immortalized secondary cell line. Next, that is established cell culture. The established cell culture is a culture of established or the immortal cell line. Yes, the established cell culture is a culture of established or the immortal cell lines, and it can be indefinite. Then the vast majority of these are derived from tumor, for example HeLa, or from a cells transformed in vitro, generated from primary cells that have undergoes mutation. Then some of the very earliest lines were established from normal embryonic tissues. Then there are also cell lines that have been widely used, such as WI38, which are from a normal human tissues and have a limited lifespan in vitro. Then these cell lines have been workhorse of the cell culture, and from their use in studying the control of the cell cycle to the vaccine production and the large-scale industrial production of recombinant protein. Then, the similar to cell in primary culture, cells in established line accumulate mutation over time, and that can change their character. Then, cell identity is verified through a process known as authentication. Yes, cell identity is verified through a process known as authentication, in which DNA profile of the cultured cell is compared against the known or the standard profile for the cell lines. Then most recently, cell lines have been developed with the aim of maintaining a normal phenotype combined with ability to grow the cells or its precursor indefinitely in a culture. Then this can be accomplished by using a conditional transformation by establishing the cell lines from stem cells or the precursor cells, in which can then be induced to differentiate into a terminally differentiated cell type in a culture. Then third, that is transformed cell culture. I will stop here. Next part we will see in next lecture.